Go ahead.
Hello. Very nice. All right. All right, ready? I feel like you're going to use that, damn it. I don't know why I do this to myself. All right. What's going on, guys? Chris here at Freedom Van Gogh. So today we're going to be doing a Espar heater install. It's going to be the S2 D2L diesel heater from Espar. And this is going to be an updated video. I know last time you guys had a couple more questions, so we're going to get a little more granular with the instructions and kind of give you guys a little more confidence when installing the heater. So let's jump into it. So obviously, if to put the heater in, we have to remove the seat. And for most vans, to remove the seat, you're going to throw an airbag code unless you do it properly. So for the NCV3s, which is the 2007s through 2018, the quick disconnect for the battery is going to be right here on the bottom. So we're going to go ahead and pull that off. It's going to cut power to the van. And then for an extra little precaution, we're going to go here to the little fuse box on the side of the driver's seat, and we're going to pull fuse number 32. So we're going to pull that. And then that'll allow it, so when you take the seat off, it's not gonna throw the airbag code when you put it back on and turn the van back on. Because if it does, unless you have a code reader or whatever yourself, you're gonna have to take it to the dealership and get it cleared, and that's not fun. So we're gonna go ahead and prep that. Some vans don't have that, but most vans do. So before you take off the seat and unplug everything, go ahead and pull the quick disconnect for the battery and fuse number 32. Okay, so let's go take off the seat. So when taking off your seat, it's kind of hard to say what kind of tools you need for the seat, because depending on the year, depending on if you have factory swivels, if you have aftermarket swivels. So basically, you're gonna remove your seat with whatever the tools needed to remove that. In this case, it's a number 6 Allen and a number 8 Allen, but it could be different depending on van to van, year to year. So once you remove the seat, you're gonna lift it off. And again, you're gonna make sure you unplug any wires that connect the seat in case you have power seats, power lumbar, airbag sensors, anything like that. So make sure you unplug the seat and then take it off. So let's do
after
that.
Unboxing your heater, it should look something like this. So what we're gonna do is we're going to take off the little seal right here that goes over all the studs, the fuel line, and the exhaust and intake. So it's gonna look like this. We're gonna take it and we're going to lay it down in the seat like this.
Little half circle, half oval. It almost fits this perfectly. So we're gonna put it just like this. So when you're looking down on it, you'll note that everything is kind of symmetrical, minus this is where the fuel line will come through. You wanna make sure that your fuel line is in this position compared to, you can move it around and it could be in the wrong position, but when you're setting this, this is important that the fuel line hole is right here. So once you have it lined up in the proper orientation, we're gonna take a marker or whatever you want to mark it with, and we're gonna mark all the holes. So put that there, here, here. And there. So you can also just take spray paint and just spray paint over it. Gives you the immediate, you know, template of it. But that's a little bit neater. So now we know where we have to drill for the orientation for the heater. So the tools you're gonna need to make the holes for your exhaust, intake, the through bolts, and the fuel line. So for the exhaust and intake, you're gonna need a 1-inch hole saw. For the 4 mounting studs, you're going to need a 5/16 drill bit. And for the fuel line, you're gonna need a 1/4-inch drill bit. Good? Yep. So after you drill the holes, it should look something like this. They should be able to put the heater down. It should easily fit through. One thing to note is the fuel line on here may move around a little bit, so you might have to play with that to get it to fit, but that's why we told you the sizes of the tools needed to make that fit. After that, we have a deeper, and we're going to go around here and make sure there's nothing sticking off the sides here, nothing that's going to help
keep it up off, you know, the mountain. So once you do all that, anytime we, you know, cut metal and expose really any metal here, you have to paint it. You don't want it to rust. So we're gonna go ahead and paint it, let it dry, and then we're gonna set the heater in. To mount the heater and through bolt it onto the van, you're gonna need a 10 millimeter socket, and to make it easier, a long extension. Because that's the size of the nuts, you're gonna put the heater on there, have the through bolts go through it, take the nuts and washers like we discussed earlier, put them on there, and then use, you know, the socket to tighten them on there. You want them really, really tight, but you don't want to like hulk it down and you know, pull the threads or do anything crazy with it. You just want it to start seating up into like the underliner of the van. You can also grind out all that underlining there and just have this nice smooth surface, but it's not required. You're just gonna get down there, tighten it basically till it's really tight. You don't have to hulk it down. There is no like traditional torque spec for it. Like, you'll know when it's tight. But again, it's gonna be 10 millimeter and an extension to make it easier. So now we're going to mount the heater to the actual van right now. So before you do that, you definitely wanna make sure you put the covering for the front side of the heater. So it'll be the big plastic piece that looks like this. So you're just gonna slide it over, and it can be tricky to slide in there, but I promise you it does fit. You just gotta play with it a little bit. Once you get that to fit, then we're gonna grab four of the nuts, and for these kind of wavy washers, they're gonna act as kind of like lock washers as well. So let's go ahead and mount this to the van. So before we mount this to the van, we definitely wanna make sure that the seal gets put back on. So you'll see on the seal, there's kind of two sides to it, a nice flat side and then a side with the lip. So you wanna put the side with the lip towards the heater itself. So this is what's gonna seal it once we put it and mount it to the actual van. This is what's gonna seal everything, because the holes might be a little bit bigger than the studs or the exhaust. We wanna make sure that this is on there in between the van and the heater, so that when we tighten it down, it'll completely seal it. So you don't have to worry about anything coming up from the bottom of the van. All right, so now that it's on there, it'll look like this. It'll fit real nice. And then now we'll put it on the van. So next we're gonna talk about the wiring harness that comes with it. It can be pretty intimidating and a little confusing. So we're gonna break it down for you guys, and again, kind of show you what you need to worry about and what we're gonna be, you know, running and stuff like that. So it's gonna look like this. We're gonna take the zip ties, we're gonna go ahead and cut them. So after you cut the zip ties, the first thing that'll come, you know, undone will be the fuel pump power line. And it's gonna be the green one. So you're gonna have one connection point already pinned up and ready to go. And then the other side is gonna be roughly 10 feet, you know, 8 feet of wire. And then it's just gonna be green wires at the end. So this is obviously to power the fuel pump, which we'll be installing later. So we're gonna take this and put it to the side for now. Note that the baggies on there are to actually pin up and get it ready to plug into the harness later on. So don't lose the baggies, leave it on there. We'll just put it to the side. So the next point we're gonna get to is the power wire. So the power wire is gonna be the next long one that's on here. It's gonna have the red and brown wire sticking out. It's gonna be, again, one of the thickest parts of the harness. Again, that's where you're gonna be getting power to your heater. So, and then here attached to that wire is the fuse for it. So leave that zip tied there, don't touch it. It's good to go, don't worry about it. So that's power wire. So the next wire on here, which is the second longest one, is going to be the Digimax D1000 control unit wire. So This obviously will be if you're going to be using that control unit. For this scenario, we're not. We're going to be using the Easy Start Pro. And so we're not going to be actually using this wire harness. So we're either going to tuck this to the side or we're just going to cut it here and forget about it. So down to the three smaller wires on the harness. So this one here, we're not going to touch. Do not cut it. Do not do anything with it. Just make sure you don't bend it here as it says on the heat shrink. We're just going to leave it to the side. Don't worry about it. Don't touch it. The next two, again, the green one should look familiar because this is the other side to the fuel pump power wire. So this is where we're going to be running it through the van to connect to the actual harness. So we'll use that later. And then this one right here is actually going to be the Easy Start Pro plugin. So we're going to be using this wire. So this is the fuel pump power line. Again, it's going to be the really thin one that has the green wires. One side is going to be just wires. The other side is actually going to have the connection on it. So we're going to drill a small hole through one of the grommets in the base of the seat, and then we're going to feed the wire through. So we're going to feed the side that does not have the connection, so just the free wires. We're going to come up from the bottom of the van and feed that through. So we drill a really small hole through that grommet just so that when you're pushing it through, it's really tight and kind of seals itself. So the bit that we use is a 7/64 bit. Again, you can go a little bit bigger if you can go a little bit smaller and just feed it through. Again, just going to push it through so it kind of seals itself. So but before we run this, we're going to go on the bottom and we're going to put this and the fuel line in some heat protection because we're going to have to run it up over the exhaust into the other side of the van. So let's hop underneath the van and we'll see kind of how we're doing it and which grommet we're going to go through.
I didn't think it was going to have to work after lunch.
Okay. I pull this through. Yeah. Yeah, you are. So when prepping the harness for power, the biggest thing to probably plan ahead of time is how you're gonna get power to your heater. So in this case, this customer already ran 10 gauge marine grade wire to the heater to give us power, which is great. I mean, that's half the battle depending on how far along your build is or how hard it would be to get power from your build already to here. But this is something you have to understand, that you have to get power, 12 volt power to your heater. So minimum gauge is 12 gauge. So run 12 volt, 12 gauge wire to your heater. However you want to, he ran it through the bottom of the floor. Another common thing is to go from the ceiling down the B pillar and into the base of the chair. However you want to do that, it just needs at least minimum 12 gauge wire to the heater. And for this case, we're going to run the power wire into the base of the chair, and then we're going to take his control unit, the Easy Start, and we're going to run it through the bottom of his floor mat up to the side over here, because that's where he wants his control unit to be. For the control unit, since there's such a long wire to it, you can really mount it anywhere that you want to. Common practice is to mount it on the base of this seat or to run it underneath the floor mat there and mount it on the base of the other seat. It doesn't really matter where you mount the control unit. You just obviously wherever you're able to get it to. So we're gonna run the wires for that and get that prep. So we'll get started on that. Good to go. So now we're going to tackle wiring up the harness. So obviously the big end right here is what's actually going to plug into the heater itself. You can only plug it in one way. It's designed that it won't fit any other way. So you're going to plug that in. But right now we're going to tackle actually getting power to the heater, which again is going to be the really long wire that has the red and brown wires inside. So it's gonna be pretty obvious. The red's gonna go to red for your power, and then brown will go to black for your power, or however you're running your power. But in this case, we have ours are black and red, red and brown. So red to red, brown to black. That's how we're gonna connect that. And again, we actually have a lot of extra wire, both on the wire coming from the power source and the wire from the harness. So feel free to cut all the slack off. You really don't need 70 feet of wire underneath your, you know, the base of your seat. So we're probably gonna cut that down and only have about 8 to 10 inches or so. You don't wanna have it like exactly the length in case you gotta move stuff. But give yourself a little slack, but obviously cut, I mean, we usually keep anywhere from like 8 to 12 inches roughly. So we're gonna cut that, give that power. And then the only thing to worry about, or I guess to not worry about, is the other really long wire. If you look down it, it'll be a bunch of different colors in there, and we're not gonna use this wire at all. So if you're, and again, this is for the Digimax 1000, which is another control unit. We're not gonna be using this for this scenario. So if you plan on not using it as well, you can just tuck this to the side. You can cut it off the harness if you decide you're never gonna use it. But for this scenario, we're just gonna take it, zip tie it, and just put it to the side and not have to worry about it. So we're gonna go ahead and put power to this, and then we're gonna go switch over and put the fuel pump power to this as well. So we'll show you how that's done.
We did that sometimes. Actually, we ran into that before, people's electrical system.
Really?
Hmm?
Oh, so they really just...
get it, they just get it going. That's about it. Cool, so this wire right here should be the wire that is coming up from the bottom of the van. This is the fuel pump power wire, again with the two green wires. So next what we're gonna do is we're going to strip this back and we're going to pin it up so that it can fit the connector that is on the harness. So this is really the only part that you need specialty tools for, but realistically, you don't have to have the specialty tools. So this is the OEM like crimpers that are meant for the special little like connectors that they have on here. I'll give you a little close-up look for them. So they're kind of special ones. They fit the harness. Realistically, if you want to buy the specialty tool, which this can be found on like Amazon, I doubt you can get this at Home Depot, but it's like 20 bucks on Amazon. If you plan on doing other intricate wiring on your van, this might be useful. But if not, you can also just go get some spay connectors. So basically, you'll just cut each side, get male end, female end, and then just crimp them, heat shrink them, and then connect them together. It does the same exact thing. They just have a fancy way to do it already on the harness. So we're gonna do it that way, just to show you guys how that's done. And then again, I mean, to connect your power lines, you're gonna have to get butt connectors anyways. So if you wanna go that route and just go ahead and get some spay connectors, you can go ahead and just skip the somewhat intricate part of the wiring. So we're gonna show you how to wire up the fuel pump power line. This is the baggie that was attached to the fuel pump power line. So this is what we're gonna be pinning up that'll connect to the harness. So we'll take that, put it to the side for right now. And then you'll see a bunch of little pins and little seals basically. So once you take the wire, cut it down to length, because obviously you don't need like 5 feet down here. I have about this much of wire exposed once you strip it back. And before you actually start to pin it, you definitely want to set these little seals in there first. And they're gonna go like this. So you want the bigger side pointing down, kind of like that.
So we're gonna do that for both wires, because if you don't do that first, you're not gonna be able to get it on there. And this kind of makes it, you know, waterproof, kind of seals it up for you. Again, not that you should be getting water in here anyways. You'll probably have a bigger problem at that point. But you know, at least your heater fuel pump wire will be all right. So this should look something like that. The next step is to grab one of the little pins. This is where it might get a little tricky here. So we're gonna want probably like that. So we want the wire portion to be crimped at the top here, the exposed wire, and then we want the part that is covered and protected, we want it to be crimped with the big ends on the back, right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and crimp it and show you again. So let's go two, so it goes one, two, three. So we're gonna go. So basically I'm gonna start here in the middle and kind of crimp it once, it gets it tight, and then I'm gonna crimp it one more time on the smaller side, and that's gonna set it. So now that's good there. So we take it, try to pull test it, it's not going anywhere, and we're gonna do the same thing for the back side. So I'll take it to the back here, put it inside. Could be a little tricky when you're trying to do it. But you're gonna take it, set it, get it to start bending. And then I just take it and I just move it down the line. And then one more. And then you know you're good is if you take it and you pull test it and it doesn't wanna move. So again, you want your wires to be crimped in the front and you want the protection part here, the green part, to be crimped in the back there. So we're gonna do the same thing for the other side. So once it's crimped, so I did the first one already, I put it in there and it'll kind of look like this. So you have to realize how it's going to connect to the harness. So it's going horizontal like that. So you actually want the ends of it to lay horizontal, not vertical like that. Otherwise it just won't accept it anyways. But once it's in there, it'll kind of look something like this, like the first one. It'll be pushed in, the little rubber seal will be pushed in. You might have to have like a little small flathead like this to kind of help the seal get set in there. But we're gonna set this one so I can show you how to do it and what to listen for. Because once you put it in there, you're gonna hear a click and then you'll know that it's set. So you might not have heard it, but it clicked. And once you hear that click, you cannot pull it back out. So you have to have like special tools to do that, and we don't even have that. We just set it. So once it's in there, you can do a quick pull test and try to pull each wire. Like that's not coming out. This one's not coming out, so I know they're in there. And if you look over here, you can see on the end that they're set and they're good to go. So last thing is just push the little seals in there. That one's in. This one is fighting me. Obviously not the crimp on the other side, the crimp was good. So now you're gonna take the little end piece here and you're going to fold it over and close it. And do it just as gracefully as I'm doing it at the moment. Nailed it, first try. So it should look something like this. So that is the finished side for the fuel pump power line that is running from underneath the van. So as you can see, this wire is coming up from that grommet that we put the very small hole in, and then now we finished it. So it should be as simple as this. You're gonna take the top part, push it down, slide it in, and it's good to go. Once you hear that click, pull that back up and it's good. So the last part that we're gonna be wiring up on the harness is the control unit. And again, we're using the Easy Start Pro. So that's why we're gonna be using this section of the harness. So this part here is just gonna be a plug. So we're gonna be pinning up the other side to match this. So we have the red wire, brown wire, blue wire with red stripe, and then we have the blue wire with black stripe. Again, you're gonna have the same wires on the other side, so it's important when we're pinning this up, we have to match them. So the blue wire with the red stripe has to go with the blue wire with the red stripe, the solid red wire has to go with the solid red, and so on and so forth. So we're gonna be using the same tool to pin it up, and this baggie right here is what we're gonna be using. It has all our pins and stuff. So for this one, this was again attached to the Easy Start Pro. So whenever you open that box, this harness should be with it and has the this little baggie attached to it. So we're gonna open this up and I'm gonna show you how to pin that. So let's go ahead and get started on there.
To help.
Yes, be a little bit more focused.
All right.
Oh, very nice. Let's see if I can do it three more times. Right now, this is the piece that it's actually gonna plug in. So what I'm gonna do is, or is what I did is I took out this orange seal on the bottom. I took it out and I lined up all my wires to match the corresponding side. So I have my red matching my red. I have my blue wire with the black stripe matching my blue wire with the black stripe, and then so on and so forth. So that when I set these, I know that they're gonna go in correctly. And it's important to do that to kind of hold it up and mock it how it's gonna go in. Cause you don't wanna put it in upside down, and cause once these pins are set, they're set. You can't really undo them without like even more like specialty tools. So again, if that does happen, you just cut all these and put spade connectors and just spade connect them all. So again, if you wanna go that route, that's actually a lot easier, but we like the pain. So we're gonna go red to red. So this is my top one here. So again, I'm always double checking, triple checking, making sure that this goes here. And you may need to give yourself some extra slack, which I'm going to do. So I thought I gave myself enough slack here on the wires, but I didn't. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cut a little more so that I'm not forcing and accidentally bend the pins or cause issues just trying to make it work. So go ahead and do that, and then we'll cover all this stuff up at the end so that we're not gonna cause an issue. So I'm gonna slide this down a little bit, pull these through, give myself that slack. Okay. So we are here. So it goes like this. So we have black with blue on top. Top, and then I have my brown on the bottom. So I'm gonna make sure that you take it and they're set. And then just to make sure, this should only be in one spot, which is in here. So yeah, so we're looking good. Those are all set. Do a little pull test on each one to make sure that we're good to go. And the last thing you'll notice is that there's this little wedge. We're gonna take that and we're going to set it inside there, because that's what's gonna split the pins so that it matches appropriately when you put it together. It does take a little bit of finagling. Again, if it feels like it's being forced, like that one felt like it was, you may have to move the pins around to get them to sit in place. But once it's in, you know you're good to go. Boom. So it should look like that when it's done. So once you know that it works, let's go ahead and take this orange seal that we pulled off the back. Let's go ahead and just seat it again. So we're just gonna take it, push it through there. Again, you might have to use a small flathead or pick of some sort, kind of get it started. And let's go ahead and seat that. We do good. It stay.
Isn't that?
So for the next part, we're gonna be working underneath the van. So we're gonna be setting the exhaust, the intake, the fuel line, and here is the two baggies that has all the brackets and the clamps associated with it. So for this next part, we're gonna be using a 7mm and a 10mm socket. So that's what we're gonna be using to tighten down the clamps for all these. So let's go through it real quick. So this, the long silver hose is gonna be your exhaust hose. The short black one is gonna be your intake hose. And obviously the really thin, clear, long one was gonna be the fuel line. So the two baggies that we're gonna need are gonna be these two baggies right here. It's gonna have, for the first big bag, it's gonna have your fuel pump for it. It's gonna have a couple gray lines and a bunch of clamps. The next bag we're gonna be using is gonna have some fuel caps or some hose fittings at the end, and then some more clamps for when we actually set the fuel line and the exhaust to when we set them to the appropriate spot, where desired spot really. So the two clamps that we're gonna need right now for the intake and the exhaust is gonna be these two clamps right here. So these two clamps are different and they're used for two different ones, so we can't get these mixed up. So for your exhaust line, we're going to be using this clamp right here. It's kind of the thicker one, and it's gonna have the 10mm head to it. And then for the intake line, we're gonna be using kind of the smaller one, the thinner one in comparison, and this is gonna have the 7mm head on it. So let's go underneath the van and we're gonna set the exhaust and intake, and then we'll go and do the fuel line. You guys doing good?
Cool. What are you doing for lunch today?
I don't know, I don't have lunch.
Bar beef. Come with me in the 80 series. Me and Nick are gonna go to the power line trail. We're gonna get stuck.
So I have John right now installing the exhaust and the intake. So right now we're gonna discuss the fuel line, and we're gonna be using the other baggie for that. So again, it's gonna have like the fuel pump bracket, it's gonna have a bunch of these little rubber hoses here and a bunch of little clamps. So we're gonna open it up and we're gonna note that there is four of these little rubber hoses, and you'll notice that three of them are the same length and there's one that's shorter. This one we're not gonna be using. You'll note that this one has a smaller end and then a bigger end. Again, we're not gonna be using the small one, so we're gonna take that and put it to the side. We are gonna be using one of the three hoses right here to mount the fuel line to the actual heater itself. So we're gonna use one hose and then two of these smaller clamps. And it's gonna be just as easy as pushing this up on the fuel line, little tap that's coming out from the bottom, putting a clamp on there, and then running the fuel line through the hose here and having another clamp on there. So obviously you want your clamps on the hose before you mount anything on there, and then you're gonna slide it up there, tighten this top one up, and then you're gonna put the fuel line on the bottom and tighten the fuel line one up.
That's so, that weird stage.
Are you there?
I was in college.
Okay, whatever.
Ugh. Do you have any idea what seat bolts are?
Jesus, man.
Want them?
I mean, I doubt he'll remember that they're there.
I mean, I don't know. We've lined up all the cans. We're like prime.
What do you mean they're almost here?
They were at that one.
So the next part we'll be installing is the actual fuel pump. So we're gonna be installing that on the driver's side next to the fuel tank. There'll be a quick connect on there on the side of the fuel tank where we're able to tap into and then run our fuel line to the pump and then from the quick connect to the fuel tank. So again, we're gonna be using the baggie that has this rubber, it's got like a rubber bracket almost to hold the fuel pump. Again, the bigger self-tapping screw, again, which is a 10 millimeter, as well as the rest of these little rubber lines. So there should be two of the long ones, not the shorter one. So we have those, and then obviously the rest of these little clamps to actually secure the fuel line too. And then we go back to this little baggie here. So this is the baggie that actually has the quick connect for the fuel. This is the rubber hose that'll go over the top of that. And then this is, again, one of the clamps that we're gonna use to clamp this to the connect and clamp the fuel line to here. So we're gonna go to the other side of the van and show you how that's done. So let's go over there. Now we're on the driver's side of the van, which is where the fuel tank's at. And at this point, we should have already had the fuel line and the power to the fuel pump ran over here. So this is where we're gonna install the actual fuel pump. So right here, you should see the quick connect. So usually it's on this side. Sometimes they run it like over the top here or maybe on the other side here, but it should be sticking off to the side. And all you gotta do is pull this, pull it off, and that'll expose the quick connect. And then we will use the one that they supplied for us. And it should just pop right in. Just like that. So now we have a way to get fuel from the fuel tank to the pump and then from the pump to the heater. So now we're gonna start wiring all that up and we'll show you the process for that. We're gonna mount our fuel pump to this side of the van right here, similarly to where we mounted the muffler. So this is the little collar that it's gonna slide through. One thing to note, right here where the fuel pump plugs into to get power, it'll say fuel and have an arrow pointing the direction where the fuel is gonna be flowing. So you obviously want the arrow to kinda have the fuel come from the fuel tank to the back here, following this arrow forward to your heater. So you don't wanna orient this wrong and have it trying to pump fuel from your heater to the fuel tank. You want it to have, obviously, from the tank to your heater. Just look on the top, it'll be marked there, letting you know the direction and how to orient it. So we're gonna slide this on here. It can be a little tricky, but you just gotta play with it, get it on there, and then we're gonna self-tap it right here on the side, and then we're gonna run our fuel lines. So before we actually wanna secure the fuel pump to the side of the van, I went ahead and prepped it by putting on the two like rubber hoses on there and clamped it down with the 7 millimeter socket. So now I pull test it, nothing's moving, but we're good to go there. So now we can secure this and then run our fuel lines to it. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. It's not gonna hurt anything. We'll go like, yeah, can you go there?
Good try.
So as you can see right here, we've already ran the fuel line that's going to the heater, and I installed that big rubber hose. As you can see how I have it oriented, so the collar part is towards the end, and you'll know because one side is really small that'll accept the fuel line, and the other side is a really big hole that will only fit over this quick connect. So I already fastened it to the quick connect. I took my extra fuel line that was hanging off, I cut a little piece, and I'm gonna join these pieces right here. And same thing, I'm gonna use these little clamps, clamp them down. That side's good. And then after that, we're going to take our fuel pump power line and set that, get rid of the slack, and this side will be good to go. What it should look like when it's all wired up and all the fuel lines are ran. Again, if you need to move it like here or there, that's totally fine. You can mount it up here, just be careful. Again, with this is your step into the van, so you don't want to go through the side there and cause potential issues. So right here above the pinch weld is the best place to put it. Again, all the wires are up out of the way. I took the quick connect up here and I zip tied it up a little bit just so that the fuel line and the power line is not rubbing on any corners or anything like that. But as you can see, everything is put together, everything is nice. We did a pull test on it. Nothing is coming undone. This is plugged in. Everything is zip tied and ran up and around so that nothing can rub on it, nothing can get caught on it. And everything is protected. So one of the last things we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be installing the actual duct that's going to go to the rear or the front of the heater, depending on how you're looking at it. This is gonna take your heat and take it basically to where you want. We traditionally mount it on the rear, on the base of the seat right here. So we already have our center hole already taped up and set. So we're gonna take a hole saw, make the appropriate size hole for this piece here that's found in your kit. This is what's going to mount to the face of this and allow the duct to go from the heater to the rear of this, allowing the heat to honestly come into your van. So we're going to go ahead and set that and we'll show you how to hook everything else inside the seat. So. With the heater installed, all the wiring ran, all the exhaust and everything ran. You want to take it outside because obviously you don't want to test it and run the heater and have exhaust inside a building. So we're running it outside right now, letting it run through its cycles. When you turn it on, sometimes it's not going to immediately turn on and produce heat. Sometimes it's got to go through its cycle. It's got to get fuel through the pump, to the pump, to the heater. So just let it run. And let it go through its cycles. It'll slowly get the fuel to there, it'll slowly start to burn the fuel, and you'll get your heat. So don't keep turning it on and off, just let it run, and if it says it's running, you'll see the blinking red around the dial, just let it run. It'll take a little bit, but let it run. If it turns off, then you'll have to go into the settings and clear the code and do a bunch of different things, but even then, all that stuff is in the booklet and it's pretty easy to do. You just clear the code and then just let it run again. So it's pretty simple. And again, nothing crazy to do. It's just knowing what to wire and honestly like decoding that harness. I know the harness isn't the easiest thing to know, but once you break it down and hopefully we helped you guys out with that, it's pretty simple. So again, if you have any questions, feel free to email us, you know, at chad@freedomvango.com, grant@freedomvango.com,
or myself, Chris, at freedomandgo.com. We're happy to help you guys out. And again, if you don't feel comfortable doing this yourself, by all means, we do install heaters here, obviously. So email us and let us know if you, you know, want to get on the schedule and let us help you out. Other than that, then let us help you live life without limits.